Hey guys, I just want to first start off with welcoming you to the first ever online state of school. My name is Zion Middleton. I'm a junior here at Eagles Landing Christian Academy. I've been here since the second grade, and I'm involved with many different activities here, including drama, soccer, mock trial, and many other things. First, I'm going to start off with talking about what school means to me. I remember it was during the school's production of Oliver, and I had the lead as the Artful Dodger. And I can just remember a kindergartner named Joshua coming up to me and telling me, "I want to be just like you." And I remember that, and I feel like I will always remember that because it touched my heart so much that I know that I have people looking up to me, and it makes me want to be a better person. Actually, a few weeks ago, I was in a production of Civil War with my friend Becca here. Becca, take it away.
Hi, my name is Becca Moore, and I've been attending ELCA for 13 years now. By the time my family finishes with ELCA, we will have been here for 15 years. So there's a lot of us in the program. With my time here at ELCA, I have done praise band, drama, chorus when I was in elementary. The most recent thing I've been involved was with the band and the marching band program. I've been in band since fifth grade and marching band since seventh grade, and I have absolutely loved my entire time in the band. It has been such a great experience where the people there really make you feel like you're a part of a family. They help you grow with your music, with your education, and spiritually with Christ, and it's just absolutely amazing.
Hey Becca, weren't you just invited to Jam Fest?
I was, actually. It's this amazing band program, and it's such an honor to be selected to be able to go. It's where the University of Georgia takes different kids from different high schools in Atlanta and around the area that come together, and we get to play in this giant orchestra, and it's absolutely amazing. It's one of the best experiences of any high school career for any band kid at all. And speaking of experiences, we can't wait to show you all the exciting things going on at Eagles Landing Christian Academy.
Thank you, Zion and Becca, for welcoming us to the 2017 State of School. Many of you know Zion and Becca because of their outstanding achievements in the arts here at our school. Zion has been involved in many of our productions. He's done a wonderful job with that. Becca leads our marching band program and has been involved in that program for many years. And we're thankful for all the gifts and talents that God has blessed them with. Well, let me also welcome you to the 2017 State of School. As you can tell, this is a different format than what we typically have. For several years, we've been doing a live event where we try to encourage our families to come out to the worship center, and we go through all the things that are happening in the school. And as we were thinking about it this year, we know that we're asking a lot from our parents. We're asking you to come out to a lot of different events, from athletic events to the arts, all of our academic nights. And so we believe it's going to be a great opportunity for you just to watch this, to sit in your own home and be able to see all the things that are happening within our school. You know, each year we come together and take some time to think about all the things that have happened here at Eagles Landing Christian Academy. And really, that's the purpose of this event, State of School. As we go through this evening, what we want to try to do is answer three questions for you. First of all, we're going to answer the question of why it is that Eagles Landing Christian Academy exists. We think it's very important for you to understand, as one of our key stakeholders, why we are here. What's the purpose of the Academy? But we also want to look at all the things that God has blessed us with over the past year. 2016 has been a great year in every area. And so we're going to look at academics, we're going to look at the arts, we're going to look at athletics and talk about the accomplishments, talk about all the things that God has done in this ministry. And then finally, what we want to do as we go through this program is we want to give you a look at where we're going. We want to take a look at all the things that are coming. We have a wonderful capital campaign that's about to be unveiled to everyone. We also have some neat things that are happening in the life of the school that you'll hear about as we go through our program tonight. So we're looking forward to this. We know this is a new opportunity, a new venue, a new way of doing things, but we feel like that it'll be a great way for us to communicate to you who we are as a school. Well, let me start by saying the same thing that I often say at these events, because I think it's the critical piece for our organization, and that's starting with the mission. You know, you're investing a lot of money in the lives of your children. Every single day, we know it's a sacrifice for them to be here. And so it's important for us to start with why we exist, why we are here serving in Henry County. You know, as you can see, our mission here is pretty clear. Our mission is we exist to glorify God by assisting parents and involving their students in a growing relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ through Kingdom education. And let me just quickly draw your attention to a couple key parts of that. First and foremost, we are here to glorify God. You know, that is really the foundation of the Academy. Everything we want to do here, we want it to glorify our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ as revealed through His Word. And so we are not just Christian in name, we want to be Christian in every aspect of the Academy. And how do we do that? Well, we do that by coming alongside of parents. You know, I believe the key to raising children in this generation is really three things. One, the church, the Christian family, and the Christian school. And so we're a part of that process. We're not all of the process, and we don't want to be all of the process, but we are a part of the process. We're coming alongside of you as parents, and we're assisting you on a daily basis to see your children grow up in Jesus Christ. We want them to have a growing relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, and we do that through Kingdom education. That is the purpose of the school. You know, I think it's important for us all to understand, though, what is Kingdom education? What is the purpose of why we exist within this community? And I think it's clearly defined this way. Kingdom education is a lifelong, Bible-based, Christ-centered process. And it does three things for our children. And this is the business that we're in. The first thing that it does is it leads a child to Christ. You know, we want you to know that when you're within this school community, that our number one priority is that your child would come to a true understanding of what it means to be a follower of Jesus Christ. We want them to be saved. That's critical for us because we know that if a child is saved, then they're guided by the Holy Spirit in their life. The next part of that in Kingdom education, though, is building them up in Christ. That is where Kingdom education comes to bear on your child within the curriculum, within our arts program, within our athletics program. It's helping them develop a Christ-centered worldview. We all know that our children are being, really, I guess you would say, attacked from every different angle with all the worldviews that are out there. It's critical right now for our students to understand what it means to have a Christ-centered, Bible-based worldview. How does God see things? And we find that as revealed in His Word, and we can show that in every content area. The next thing is for them to go out and serve. How do we equip that child to go out and serve Jesus Christ? And you'll hear more throughout this program about our World Impact programs and how we are being intentional about sending those students out to do great things for Christ. Well, you know, one of the things that we're always thankful for is how God is using our alumni. And so we wanted to show you guys a quick video of Christian and Kimmy White. They're alumni of this school. They are a group of people who we would say truly embody what it looks like in Kingdom education, how God is using them in ministry today. So take a look at this video.
Eagles Landing Christian Academy and Eagles Landing First Baptist have played such an important role in our life. One of the biggest roles that it played in our life is really seeing us come to know the Lord. For Kimmy, that was in middle school. For me, that was last semester senior year of high school. It was in high school that I began to see what true Christianity looks like, and that was really demonstrated clearly through this church and through the school. And for us right now, we're in the middle of an exciting journey of seeing a church planted in an area that desperately needs the gospel. Our conviction is that we would begin to win people over to Christ through showing the value of what does it mean to be truly Christian in a place that has not experienced the gospel and has not experienced true Christianity. And so for us, that points us back to our experience at Eagles Landing First Baptist and Eagles Landing Christian Academy. If we want to be vibrant believers who live out consistently what we truly believe, and we're guided by that in everything that we do.
It played the biggest role in who I have become as a believer in Christ, as a wife, as a mom. I really want to take just the consistent investment of love and grace that I saw at Eagles Landing First Baptist and at ELCA, and I want to translate that into the relationships that I meet, the people that I meet in Atlanta.
We just want to say thank you for the way that the school and the church has invested in us. And to think that, I know for me, a lot of people thought that I was a lost cause, but because of faithful people, you know, we're at the place where we are, and the Lord has used those types of people in our life. And so we really just want to say thank you and just encourage you to keep going to achieve greater things.
Well, obviously, we're very proud of Christian and Kimmy and the great work that they're doing. Be in prayer for them. They have a wonderful opportunity to minister in the Atlanta area. And they are children who've grown up in this school who are now adults that are going out and doing great things for the Lord. We consider that to be a great win for the Academy, and we're looking forward to how God continues to use them. You know, when you think about our school and the ministry that God has blessed us with here, the school was founded in 1970. And so what that means is really over 45 years this ministry has been serving within this community. For those of you who might not be familiar with the ministry, in 1994, Eagles Landing First Baptist Church took over Eagles Landing Christian Academy. And since 1994, over 1,100 students have graduated from the academy and gone out. Many of them today are doing great things for the Lord, and we're so thankful for the work of our alumni, not only within this community, but literally around the world in a lot of different areas. You know, over the past 5 years in particular, one of our focal areas for the school, and you'll hear this as we go through the program, has been improving and strengthening the academic culture. You know, a lot of times people think in terms of Christian schools as being a place where you go to hear about Jesus, but not a place where you would go to get a strong academic education. So if you're a student within our school and you struggle academically, we have a student support service program that comes alongside of you and works with you every single day. We really have one of the best programs on the south side of Atlanta when it comes to working with students with diagnosed learning differences. We also have our Aerosmith program, which is one of a kind in this area in working with brain-based learning to help students develop and achieve within the classroom. But more than that, we reach all levels of students, not only our students who are our average students. We have a strong college prep program, but then those who are above average and need our honors program and our AP program. One of the things we've done over the past 5 years is invest in that, class sizes, extending our AP programs. The other thing we want for our students is we want them to have a strong fine arts opportunity and a strong athletic opportunity. And so what you find within our students is the vast majority of them are involved in every one of those areas. We don't want to just offer those. We want to be competitive, and we also want to seek championships. And you'll see as we go through the program that we've achieved that, and we're thankful for those blessings. One of our major focal areas for 2016-2017 has been Advanced Ed. As you've heard in many of our communication pieces, this is a reaccreditation year for us. It's time for us to go through the 5-year review process. This is a very detailed process that every single staff member within our school is involved in. Everyone is represented on a committee. They're all working on the standards that are sent to us from Advanced Ed. And coming in March, there's going to be a team of educators that will be coming to our school and will be evaluating all of our processes, looking within our classrooms and seeing that we meet the standards. We're excited for them to come because a lot of work has been done. A lot of the things you'll even see in this program are a reflection of all the work that's happened. But in particular, I wanted to draw your attention to some of the survey information that we received from our stakeholders. We sent surveys to all of our stakeholders. We sent them to students, we sent them to staff, and we sent them to parents. And we asked them a lot of questions about how we align with the standards. And in particular, there were several things that came back to us which were considered areas of notable achievement. And I want to recognize those for just a moment. One is that we heard from you is that you feel like we have a comprehensive process in place related to our school's purpose for student success. Meaning basically that you see that we have a process where your child is going to be successful within the classroom. And that's very much in line with what we're trying to achieve. As I mentioned earlier, meeting the needs of all of our students through differentiated instruction is key for us to be successful in the classroom. Another area of notable achievement that you recognized was that there was widespread satisfaction from parents and staff regarding the purpose and direction of the school. That's a critical piece for us as an institution because we want you to see that there is a direction that we're heading and that we know where we're going and what it takes to get there. We know that's a process. We know that we're not perfect at it, but we were thankful that you recognized that there is a plan in place for what we want to see, not only in your child's life, but in the institution as a whole. And finally, another area of notable recognition from our stakeholders was that parents expressed confidence in our facilities, services, and equipment to provide a safe, clean, and healthy environment for the students. You know, each year when we survey our parents, the number one thing they say as to why they remain a part of Eagles Landing Christian Academy is Kingdom education, environment. Always a close second to that is safety and security. And that's very important for us, not only to maintain safe and secure facilities, and you'll see as part of our new capital campaign how we want to focus on that even more, but also we want to create an environment, a healthy environment for your child where they can flourish. You know, I'm excited about this program, excited about showing you all of these things. And at this point, we're going to transition now to give you a great overview of what's happening within the academic culture of our school.
Hi, my name is Cindy George. I'm the Dean of Academics here at Eagles Landing Christian Academy. I'm very excited to share with you the excellent academic program for our school. As we continue to embrace a culture of academic excellence, our ultimate goal never changes. We take great pride in embracing a culture of excellence through a strong biblical worldview, which serves as the foundation of our academic program. Our expansive PK-12 curriculum ensures that our students receive exposure to a variety of disciplines, preparing them to apply, analyze, synthesize, and evaluate through a biblical lens. Our Excel, Honors, and Advanced Placement programs, as well as our student support services, offer the rigor and relevance necessary to provide our students with the preparation for success after high school. Our teachers have worked diligently to ensure K-12 alignment of curriculum, instruction, and assessment through disciplines such as English Language Arts, Mathematics, Social Studies, Science, and Foreign Language, while incorporating a biblical worldview to reinforce mastery of core knowledge and Christian virtue. This work has resulted in new approaches to our curriculum, new assessments such as the ACT Aspire, and new instructional strategies in the classroom. Our grade-level vertical teams routinely analyze data from benchmark assessments aligned to the college readiness standards to develop specific grade-level goals, along with consistent biblically integrated process goals for K-12 instruction. These school improvement goals enable us to have a clear and shared focus for increased student achievement. In order to be consistent in the implementation of best practices in the classroom, our faculty and staff work collaboratively in professional learning communities every Thursday, where we learn key strategies for biblical worldview integration, differentiated instruction, depth of knowledge, and assessment. Our Charger Thursday sessions reinforce our clear and shared focus for curriculum, instruction, and assessment. God has blessed us with an outstanding academic program and continues to afford us with a plethora of opportunities for our students. Our K-12 Spanish curriculum has been rewritten to offer students a complete immersion into foreign language as Spanish is taught through a TPRS format, meaning teaching proficiency through reading and storytelling. As a matter of fact, our upper elementary students will be reading Spanish novels this semester. Our K-12 computer science program introduces elementary students to appropriate technology usage and tools that are essential in today's technological society. It provides our middle school students with an introduction to computer programming, web design, animation, and image editing. Computer programming and web design provide a pathway for high school students that could lead to some of the biggest paying and fastest growing jobs in America. The ELCA Merit program has been renovated and continues to offer a unique blend of computerized instruction coupled with individualized direct instruction. It is through this cutting-edge program that we are able to provide a college prep curriculum to students who may not be successful in a traditional style classroom. Merit classrooms are truly conducive learning environments that afford struggling students an opportunity to thrive and experience academic success. Our preschool continues to lay the foundation for students as the curriculum focuses on the components of a preschooler through spiritual, academic, and personal development. At the elementary level, we are providing mathematics ability grouping in grades 3, 4, and 5 to meet the needs of our varied learners. In addition, our elementary program continues to thrive in specialized offerings through instructional technology, art, music, our Excel classes, robotics, numerous ACSI competitions, mental math, and a new program that we've added this year, Odyssey of the Mind. Our middle school teachers have worked diligently to develop and implement 4 new honors level courses, bringing a total of 11 honors courses to our middle school. Our middle school teachers do a great job with technology integration through Google Classroom, iXL, and Khan Academy. And of course, there are numerous clubs that extend our middle school curriculum, such as robotics, math, science, chess clubs, and a new club that we've added this year, Aviation Flight Simulator. Our middle school students have the opportunity to participate in the Duke Talent Identification Program, as well as numerous ACSI competitions. At the high school level, we continue to add to our very robust AP program with the addition of AP Macroeconomics and AP Computer Science principles, resulting in 17 course offerings with an enrollment of 45% of our total student population. The AP program is supported by 19 honors level courses. Our teacher-to-student ratio is approximately 1 to 18, offering a very personalized learning environment. The Governor's Honors Program is a very competitive academic program in which students must participate in a rigorous application process that includes a statewide interview and audition. The students you see pictured have just completed a state application for the 2017 competition. However, it's my privilege to announce that Jake Dallas was selected from over 3,000 students in the state of Georgia as a 2016 state GHP finalist. It's my pleasure to introduce Jake, who will provide a few comments about his experience here at ELCA.
Hey, I'm Jake Dallas. I'm a senior at ELCA, and I just wanted to talk about some of my experience I've had in the last 3 years since I've gotten here, since my sophomore year high school. ELCA has been a great experience for me. I've had a lot of great times here. I've been able to learn a lot just in every field, whether it be like in physical disciplines, whether it be in spiritual disciplines, or just basic academic disciplines. I've had a lot of beliefs challenged in the best way. I've had a lot of thoughts that I've not been able to have before. I've been able to, expand my mind. I've been able to become a better writer. I've been able to become a better reader. I've been able to become a better thinker in general. I've had so many opportunities, be it from fine arts, which is a thing I never considered before. I got to be in drama. I got to be in our production of Beauty and the Beast. I got to be in our production of The Crucible of Civil War, and we'll be in Les Mis upcoming in the spring. I've also gotten to do some great things when it comes to athletics with wrestling and football. But even beyond that, I've had some great relationships with my teachers. I've had some fantastic teachers like Dr. Balti, Miss McKnight. I've had some extracurricular opportunities that I've been nominated for, like the Governor's Honors Program. I was nominated by Mr. Edmondson and by Miss McKnight. I actually got to spend a summer in Valdosta State right after my junior year. And it's really prepared me for college. It's really prepared me for moving forward. And I feel like without ELCA, I would really have never gotten there. Not even just because I wouldn't have gotten nominated, but because I wouldn't have learned the skills necessary to compete on that sort of level. I feel like from ELCA, I've really been able to grow as a person on every level. I've really been able to come into myself. You know, since I came my sophomore year, I feel like I'm much more ready to go out into the world. I'm actually planning to attend GCSU next fall. I got the presidential scholarship there through some an academic scholarship, and I would never achieve that without some of my fantastic teachers at ELCA, some of the fantastic disciplines I've been able to go through. And I'm honestly really grateful to everything ELCA's provided for me, and I'm really glad to have my high school experience here. And I think that ELCA is a fantastic place if you want to learn, if you want to grow as a human being. And I really feel like here, spiritually, mentally, physically, on every level, I've become the best that I could possibly be and have gotten more and more ready to impact the world.
And of course, the class of 2016 produced some outstanding academic statistics with 32 AP scholars. one national AP scholar, the county and region star student, a state governor's honors finalist, one national merit finalist, three Georgia scholars, an average SAT score of 1546, with the top 10% posting an astounding score of 2117, an average ACT score of 22.7, with the top 10% posting a 31.8. The class of 2016 was accepted to over 101 colleges and universities and will attend 45 different post-secondary institutions. Approximately 10% of the class of 2016 had enough AP credits to enter college beyond the freshman level status. Members of the class of 2016 were afforded approximately $7.5 million in grants, athletic, and academic scholarships. Our complete academic program affords our students opportunities to be competitive academically for admissions into some of our country's top public, Christian, and private colleges and universities. In the past 10 years, our students have attended over 140 different post-secondary institutions, including the Naval Academy, Messiah, Wheaton, Georgia Institute of Technology, Georgetown, the University of Chicago, Penn State, Tulane, and UGA, just to name a few. As we look at evaluating excellence, our faculty has spent the past 18 months implementing a careful analysis of teaching and learning, leadership capacity, and resource utilization as an ongoing process to improve student performance in grades PK through 12. This self-evaluation process has served as the foundation for our upcoming March accreditation visit by Advanced Ed. As the March accreditation visit approaches, we are excited to share ELCA with the visiting team. The external review team will identify powerful practices and provide us with improvement priorities. This information will drive the future focus of our school improvement efforts. It is our prayer for the visiting team to see ELCA as a distinctly Christian and academically excellent institution that strives to maintain an optimal environment for student learning. As we look ahead in embracing academic excellence for the 2017-2018 school year, we are constantly assessing ways we can improve our instructional programs. The improvement priorities and opportunities for improvement as identified by the Advanced Ed Review Team will serve as a catalyst for school improvement for the next 5 years. This process will enable us to examine rigor and relevance in all curricular areas. In addition, plans are underway to investigate the development and implementation of a STEM program across all grade levels. We are very excited to announce our recent partnership with Truett-McConnell University in offering dual credit courses for the 2017-2018 school year. This partnership will allow our students to receive high school and college credit through a biblical worldview curriculum. Although we continue to seek ways to improve our academic programs, we realize that we must always be mindful of being mission-centric. Through God's blessings, Eagles Landing Christian Academy is able to equip students to embrace biblical truth, to strive for academic excellence, and to impact others for Jesus Christ. We thank you for the opportunity to partner with you as we all seek to grow and nurture our students spiritually, academically, emotionally, and physically for life and eternity.
It is truly amazing to see how God has blessed us in the area of academics. That culture has grown immensely over the past 5 years, and we're very thankful to Cindy George and her team who continue to pour into that. And as we transition now into another part of who we are, not only do we want to see our children growing in the area of kingdom education within the classroom, but we also want to send them out. And a big way in which we do that is through our World Impact Program. And so we're going to hear from Holly Kapp and one of our students to talk about how World Impact is impacting the culture of Eagles Landing Christian Academy.
Hi, my name is Holly Kapp, and I have the privilege of working here at Eagles Landing Christian Academy with our World Impact program. That program is for our high school students, and it gives them the opportunity to step outside the classroom and to be able to put their faith into action, working with quite a few different cultures throughout the world. Since 2005, we've been able to go to around 20 countries or places, helping with feeding the poor, with doing medical care, providing English as a second language, with doing vacation Bible school. In the country of Honduras, every year we pass out about 300 pamphlets to probably about 12 villages, and it's school supplies that they wouldn't get otherwise. Our families are able to send their students on these trips and joyfully do that. There's about 50% of our population, between 40 and 50% of our population travels each year. We have Africa this year. We have New Orleans this year. We have Alaska, and we have Nicaragua, and we have Jamaica, and we have Honduras. Those are our mission-focused trips, but in addition to that, we have academic and kind of cultural historic trips. This year, we'll be going to England. Last year, we were able to go to Paris and Normandy, and the year before that, we did Italy, and we've done Greece as well, and Budapest. We don't know where we're going next year, but please be looking for that and jump on the train if you would like to go with us. We have the reason that we do this, the reason that we send students each year, is because we want them to understand that faith without works is dead. And we want them to understand that they have to go and share Christ. It says that, you know, how would people know if people had not come? And so we are those that are going, and we want our students to see that and to know that. We want them to be those that go and fulfill that passage that says, you know, if you've done this to the least of these, you've done this unto me. And so our students do go and feed the poor. They do go and give water and nutrition, both physically and spiritually, to these communities that they get to be a part of. Each year, we try to send the students out during their spring break. We try to send them out at times that are as least interruptive to their academics as possible. And we're very grateful that their teachers accommodate this. This year, will be going pretty much all of our trips. We'll travel in April during spring break. But there are some trips that have gone out during winter break as well. Our Nicaragua trip and our New Orleans trip both go out at that time. I have a student here with me today, Alex Johnson, who has gone with us for three years, to see the people of Honduras. And each year he has just felt called back there because of the impact that it's made on his life. It's prepared him not just physically to go out in the world, he's a senior this year, but it's also prepared him emotionally and spiritually to go and to enter in that next season of life. Mm-hmm. So Alex, why don't you tell us a little bit about your experiences?
Okay, well, again, as you said, my name is Alex Johnson, and I've been going here for 6 years, ever since I was in the seventh grade. And next year, I'll be moving on to the University of Georgia. But what really called me back to Honduras, I would say, after my first year, is I guess the people there. They were something I couldn't really let go of. I remember when I came back to the United States, like the day after we got back, I almost felt lonely. Like it was something, they became a part of me, something that I wanted next to me, even though I've only been there for just 10 days. Honduras was something just so special to me, something quiet, something where I could just focus on helping other people and serving God. And there was no distractions, no cars, TV shows, Netflix, solely helping and working God. Also, Honduras brought me a new perspective on gratefulness. You know, the people there have nothing, and that's where we live, with the people. I was literally sleeping next to some people or outside with others, and you could see the gratefulness on their face. You know, we gave them sometimes our leftover meal if I didn't really want it, and they would eat it up in a second, where I would probably, you know, in the cafeteria, not touch somebody's food that they just ate. So I came back, and you know, the first day I turned on my hot water, and I was like, hot water, you know, and I was, it was a new sense of gratefulness, and it's been with me for the past 3 years since I've gone. I know it impacted me gratefully and everybody else, because every year we have a day to where everyone signs up for the trips. I would say almost it's a righteous hostility that morning, because everybody is wanting to go on these trips so bad, because each and every trip is impacted. I know that in Jamaica, that's probably one of the most popular trip of our grade. You sit there and you build houses and give food, give water, and it's a great opportunity as well. And also in Honduras, you actually do medical work. Like, I was firsthand with a U.S. surgeon helping remove a cyst. It's a great opportunity for college. I mean, that's 10 days of community service hours. I use that on all my applications for the University of Georgia, many college essays as well. I mean, it's not just a mission trip, but also could be benefiting me in the future. Cultural societies, you get to experience many different things, help you in many different classes, many different aspects in the world. And that, you know, that's just something I really enjoyed. And I'm going back this year, my final year, or actually maybe not. I want to go back after this year, but it's going to be something special, hopefully.
Well, and we have really appreciated all of our students that have gone on the trip. Alex is not unique in his story. The recidivism rate is very high for our students that want to that go to a place and then want to return to that place. And many of our alumni have been able to continue their desire to serve in international and even domestic missions because of their experiences at ELCA. So we're very grateful to you guys that pray for us and that make this opportunity available. Thank you.
We appreciate Holly and Alex sharing with us what it's like to be a part of our World Impact Program. We consider that to be a core of who we are, taking our students and allowing them to go out into the world, and what wonderful opportunities they have. Many of them have gone on into college and are now doing things around the world and utilizing the tools that God has blessed them with. Well, we'd like to transition now and recognize some of our athletic accomplishments over the past year. And, you know, oftentimes this is an area of focus for a lot of our families, and we see athletics as just one more part of Kingdom education. It's a chance for us to share Jesus Christ with our students. It's a chance for us to train up young men and women through their athletic abilities to go out and minister for Jesus Christ. You know, since we joined the Georgia High School Association in 2004, we've seen a lot of accomplishments. We've had 28 different Final Four appearances, 4 state runners-up, 14 team state championships, and 23 individual state championships. It's been awesome to see how the Lord has worked in our program. We're thankful for the coaches and the athletes that are a part of those programs that have allowed us to have that level of success. As we've looked at the past year, there's been a lot of neat things that have happened in several of our athletic areas. In our girls' athletic program in particular, we've seen some amazing highlights. Our girls' basketball team, varsity level basketball team, reached the Final Four for the first time in school history. A lot of things came together for them to be able to accomplish that. They were very close to beating an amazing basketball team to go on to the state championship, but fell just a little bit short. And we did want to take a second just to recognize the talents and abilities that God had given them. It was also awesome to see in our track program that we had 6 individual state champions this past year in both our girls and our boys program. Tiaja Cameron won the 100 and 200 meter at state. Abigail Rogers won the shot put at state. And our girls 4x100 relay team won the state championship. That consisted of Parker Penholster, Kaylin Tomlinson, Palmer Penholster, and Tiaja Cameron. Our girls 4x400 team also won the state championship. Again, that was Parker Penholster, Kaylin Tomlinson, Ansley Good, and Tiaja Cameron. And then our boys 4x100 relay team of Eric Motes, Justin Menard, Sean Queen, and Jeffrey Uzel won the state championship. Just a great opportunity for our students, but also great for our school to see that many champions in our track program. You know, it's neat for us to see our students leaving ELCA and going on to compete at the college level. We currently have 43 student athletes that are competing in colleges and universities literally around the country. And we're thankful that not only do they use this to help pay their tuition, but also it's a chance for them to showcase the talents that God has blessed them with and also to expand Kingdom education to those universities. We had 20 students this past year who signed college-level scholarships to go on and compete at the next level. It was also neat to see this past year that our girls program won the GHSA Director's Cup. For those of you who may not be familiar with that, the Georgia High School Association awards this to programs who've gained the most points through their athletic program. It was neat to see our girls program over the course of the 2015-2016 school year get this, and this was a first for our athletic program, and we definitely wanted to recognize it and congratulate our female athletes for the great job in 2016. Finally, in the area of athletics, we wanted to recognize our football program, who brought home their second consecutive Georgia High School football state championship, a 14-0 record ending in the Dome in a wonderful game against Fellowship Christian. And I'm joined by Coach Guess, our football coach. Coach, this is your 10th year being here, second consecutive state championship, third since you've been here. Tell us a little bit about the season this past year.
That was a great season. You know, in 2015, we lost 12 seniors that were really, really good seniors. And we had a great sophomore class that was rising juniors. But our senior class was small. We only had 10 guys in our senior class. And I didn't know how it was going to go in 2016. Didn't know if we could repeat. So it was real exciting watching the kids grow, watching those 10 seniors, each and every one of them, taking a vital role leadership-wise, whether it be in the locker room or on the field. And watching those sophomores mature into juniors and really be a catalyst to propel us to the 2016 state championship.
It was amazing. And the fellowship game was difficult, more difficult maybe than we had anticipated as fans, maybe not for you.
Yeah, it really was a game that I anticipated it being difficult because I had watched film of them and I called them a group of winners. They're a group of kids, nothing wowed you about them when you watched film of them. However, they always won, and they won by a lot. So they were a group of winners. So I knew it was going to be a hard-fought battle. I did think we were going to win. I didn't think it was going to go to second overtime to win it. I said that I think that says a lot about the character of our football team. They could have laid down. They could have felt sorry for themselves. But at the end of the day, I think with that junior and senior class, they're just a bunch of competitors, and they're winners too, and they refuse to lose. So it made for an exciting game, probably too exciting that we believe, but I'm really proud of what they accomplished.
I guess finally would be, you know, what is the purpose of ELCA Athletics, ELCA football for you? You say it every time you take the stage when we won a state championship, but maybe put it into words for our parents and stakeholders to hear.
Well, I believe that ELCA football is a tool that we use to build young men for Jesus Christ. You know, anything that we do, everything has to glorify God. That's why He's created us, and we always wanted to make disciples. And so that's what football is. I mean, it's fun just playing football. We're competitors. We want to win. I could do anything, and I want to win. But the goal is to teach young men. You're not winning for yourself. You're winning for a higher purpose. You're becoming excellent to magnify the name of Jesus Christ, to glorify Him. And hopefully, you know, what they learned through their time in ELCA football, that it wasn't about them. It wasn't about football. That in whatever you do, you're to bring glory and honor to God, and you're to go forth and make disciples in any endeavor that you end up in later on in life.
That's right. Also, Coach, congratulations to you. 100 wins in 10 years here at ELCA. It's an amazing milestone for any coach, and we're thankful for all of your hard work here. We appreciate Coach Guess. We appreciate our football program. But in the area of athletics, what we want our stakeholders to hear is that their purpose is always going to come back to building up these young men and young women for Jesus Christ. The last area we want to highlight is our fine arts program. If you've been around our school for any amount of time, you know that it has progressed immensely over the past few years and all the things that we're offering to our students. And I'm thankful for Chuck Eckstead and his leadership within the Fine Arts program. And tell us a little bit about what's been happening with facilities this past year.
A lot. And it's been great to see the school and the administration really come on board. For instance, we started guitar classes years ago. And it started out with the idea that we'd have one or two beginning guitar classes. The students would take a year of guitar and then roll on to something else. Well, we have 5 guitar classes now. In fact, we're even talking about adding an advanced guitar class. Students are signing up for guitar and staying in it year after year. They're actually coming to ELCA and studying guitar. So this year, we set up a full-time guitar class. We took a room and we moved all the guitars into it, and we completely outfitted it to be a guitar training center. All the toolboxes and all the equipment and all the amplifiers and all the parts and pieces that make education great in a guitar class are permanently set in one place. Something else we did this year was we used to have our elementary art classes in a pretty small classroom because that was the only room with the sink. And so we were kind of contained in there because that's where we could wash up the paint. Well, it was tight, and it was hard to be creative. It was hard to work the kids in learning groups. So we took the wall up between that room and another classroom, and we've tripled the size of our elementary art room, which is so wonderful as far as teaching. You can put kids in different learning groups in different sections. They can work at their own pace. The instructor can move from to this table and that table. And the kids will have different abilities and different interests. You can actually break them up into smaller groups. So it's really increased learning in the classroom.
Yeah. And curriculum instruction is a key part of what we're doing, especially with Advanced Ed coming to look at our school. And in particular, a lot of times people think that when you're in a fine arts classroom, there's not as much of a focus on curriculum instruction, but it's a big part of what we do.
Well, it is, and we're mapping the curriculum now. So where kids are learning what in elementary school what they need to study in middle school to be ready for the middle school levels of the classes. Same thing, the middle school kids are getting ready for high school. One initiative I'm really pushing hard for next year is to have the high school band and the middle school band, instead of being based on just grade level, it'll be based on skill level, to where a child will be auditioned, and if he's superior, performs excellently, he'll be in the top wind ensemble, which is the top performers in the whole school. So that class will be made up of the best, and they'll all be trained at that level. We tend to have kids who, they could be a sixth grader, but they've had 5 years of private clarinet lessons, and they need to be in a more advanced program. We also have students in the ninth grade who decide they want to study music. And so the first time they've touched a bassoon is the ninth grade. Well, we don't want all those high school kids in high school just because they're high school kids. We want to get the kids in appropriate learning groups. So we're working next year on having skill-based classes. So where the students will start in elementary school, they'll start elementary music, they'll start playing the recorder, and then they'll go into an appropriate place, skill-based classroom to continue to study music.
And obviously, too, we want our students to not only play in elementary, middle school, and high school, or whatever they may be a part of, but we want them to go on and do things professionally, do it at the college level. Ultimately, we want them to do it in some way of serving the Lord as well.
Absolutely, so. And that's probably the most exciting thing that's happening now is, I've mentioned guitar, where the students are actually studying guitar at ELCA to advanced levels, and students are now they're coming to us and saying, I want to be a career in the fine arts. And a lot of times it is ministry. A lot of times I want to be a praise and worship leader. And with the way the classes are set up now, that we're setting the kids into professional clubs and professional organizations. Like in theater, the kids this year, we had 14 more kids sign up for the International Thespian Society, Troop 5312. And it's an organization that's international, and it tracks what the students are doing within their medium. If it's theater, every time they do a show, or even if it's working backstage, it's tracked at headquarters. So when they apply for college scholarships or college entrance exams, they can say, I'm a platinum level member in the International Thespian Society. It's quantifiable. It's measurable to school boards, and they can even take it on into their professional career, and it's something that people will recognize. For the first year ever, we're doing it in the arts. We have 23 kids signed up for the National Arts Honor Society this year. It's the same thing for the visual arts students. Their careers and their portfolios are tracked. And it's something measurable that college boards and entrance exams and even in the professional world will look at that and say that's something we recognize and give value to it.
Well, one of the other areas that we want to see with our students is we want to give them opportunities to be adjudicated and also to perform. So maybe touch a little bit on some of our past performances we've had past year and some of the things we're looking forward to in the spring.
We're doing some really fun, great shows. But I want to encourage you, if you like the arts at all, and if come out to the, when you see it performed, advertised that the high school chorus is going to perform, come on out and listen to them. It's free and they're magnificent. If you see advertised in the e-news that the high school symphonic band is going to play, come out and listen to them. And of course, our theater shows have just been amazing. I'm also the director of theater. Last spring we did Beauty and the Beast, just an amazing show. The kids did so good. And this spring, on April 27, 28, and 29, we're going to do Les Mis. That is the musical. That's going to be the toughest gig I've ever put on. But I just came from auditions, and the kids are magnificent. Do not miss Les Mis. And we just did Cinderella was our winter show for our middle school class. Lots of performances. Probably the big thing we just did was our Come Together Christmas concert. We came together with all of the fine arts department, came alongside of the church, and they performed a huge concert with like 400 people on stage, simultaneously performing. I'll never forget our elementary singers, our Young Charger Honor Chorale, performing backup for Mark Hall of Casting Crowns. Just a neat opportunity. The fine arts at ELCA are going to the next level, in every aspect of learning music and learning the arts, and the kids are getting tremendous opportunities that they wouldn't get elsewhere. It's wonderful.
Absolutely. Fine arts are important in our school. It's something we want to invest in with our facilities, with our students, with our teachers. We're looking forward to how God continues to work in that program. It's been an exciting 2016. It's going to be neat to see how God continues to work in the fine arts program moving forward. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this new format of State of School. We wanted to do this because we know that you're very busy. We know that your schedule can be overwhelming at times, and we hope that this is a benefit for you as you're able to sit down and see all the things that are happening within our school. I hope you know from me to you that our goal here is that your children would come to an understanding of Kingdom education. We want to create here a strong academic culture where they see that. We want them to be involved in championship fine arts and athletic programs. And we're thankful that you've chosen to be a part of this ministry. Now I'd like for you to hear from our pastor and our president, Tim Dowdy, as he shares with you some of what our future is going to look like through our Greater Things campaign.
As you can tell from what you've already heard, the upcoming school year is going to be one of our most remarkable years yet in the history of ELCA, and we're really excited about what's taking place. One of the most exciting developments in the life of our school and church family is what we're calling Greater Things. It's actually an expansion campaign for our school campus. We're trying to reshape and remodel our campus, refurbish everything that we have so that this is a state-of-the-art campus. And we're actually joining hands, church and school, to accomplish the purposes for that. And I'd love for you to come to be a part of what we're going to describe on Super Bowl Sunday, which is February 5th at 11 o'clock, for one service as we lay out the plans for all that's taking place in the life of the school and the church as far as our campus renovation is concerned. And so I'd love for you to come be a part of that and share in that together. It's really going to take all of us doing our part to see that become a reality. And so we're really excited about what's taking place in our academics and athletics and other extracurricular activities that are related to the school life, and can't wait to see how God's going to unfold this plan as we move toward 2017-2018 school year. So we'd love for you to join us on February 5th. We have one service that day at 11 o'clock as we talk about Greater Things. And as always, it's our privilege and honor to be a part of your family's lives and impact your children through the process of education and modeling for them what a life that's following Christ looks like. And we just pray that God would bless you and your family, give you a great rest of the school year this year, and we look forward to seeing you in 2017-2018 here at ELCA.